macho. Okay, so I traded Anthony Duclair because I believe he isn't going to do much. So I traded his ass for Nick Ritchie. I thought he's younger and he grows way better than Duclair ever has for me. So.
Really knowledgeable fan base here, guys. We know when we come in and talk to people how excited they are about the history of hockey here in Minnesota. They talk about their college programs. They talk about their high school program.
No, there's a shot that seemed a bit late.
I would be surprised, Doc, if there's not an answer for that. Well, I can't say I was exactly ready for this. I was halfway through a drink of water before the gloves go down, and they're trying to inject a little bit of energy into the game, and they'll do that with this team.
And this fight has ended with one last solid punch.
Great hands for not only scoring, but also knocking out his opponent.
More times than not, you drop your gloves like that, you're going to spend at least 5 minutes in the box.
Minnesota's stretch of their last 10 games have been pretty horrific. They've given up a pile of goals and they've scored very little. You don't have to be very good at math, Doc, to realize that has to change. It has to start for them, though, in their defensive zone. They've been porous over the last couple of weeks.
And the loose puck gathered in by Spurgeon.
Because I feel like I wasn't going to re-sign Duke players, so I thought I might as well get something for him.
Pitching this one to Saw. Looking to Niederreiter. Now it's directed to Nyquist. Poke checked away by Kane. He's got him against the glass. Chicago's in their own end and in control of the puck. Onside. Shot deflected. Terrific pad save. Puck controlled by Eric Staal.
I tried to get Matthias at home. I was going to trade Duclair for him. Then I realized I'd send out Dahl and like half of my decent defensemen, so I just didn't bother. Hoping I'd catch his first goal on camera. Richie going in.
Gets across, looks over his options. Wonderful block. He caught it anyway.
Ooh, Vasilevskiy robbing him.
The
Green Cat up to Richie.
Fires a shot. Great save. Wonderful wrist shot. He gets that pass ahead in stride.
tried to trade Russell, but didn't think it was worth it. Because I did try to put him, it was going to be him and Duclair in that trade, but then I seen Nick Ritchie, and I was like, the value is about equal. They want Duclair, but they don't want to give up Nick Ritchie. I'll see. And they said, yeah, so. If they wouldn't have, I would have probably went for, I'm not complaining, but that's weird. And it's for holding. Chicago's power play opportunity number took that right away. Play by Patrick Kane. A shot tipped. Outstanding save. What magic to even get the shot away.
A quick developing play right in front. Almost looks like he's too close for the goaltender.
Big chance here. Got in front of another one. Snapping a pass to Kane. Into the end of attack. He scores! Three straight goals.
He shot that puck so hard, I only saw it when it finally came back out of the net. No, I did. We loved scoring up there, didn't we? Right up underneath the bar, he beat the goalie over the glove hand. He's not so confident anymore.
Face-off win, and now what will they do with
it? We are outplaying the Minnesota Wild tonight, boys. This has been a good game for us. Duclair for Stahl. I could have seen that one went through. But I mean, I got DeBrincat coming up, so him and Villano are going to be my centers of the future. My 1-2 punch. And if DeBrincat doesn't experience growth, and then I'll trade him. Plain simple. You can get something for him. Whereas in Seattle, he's fucking, he's a beast. He's my team captain up there.
Didn't get through. iced tea all the way. What a game. Minnesota's in their own end and on the move. Roped in by Russell. Gets in. What'll he do? Shoots one. Wonderful save. Scorches one. Score! Four unanswered goals. From a horrible angle, he got just enough of the puck and it ended up beating the goaltender.
Whoa, it looks like his trapper's got a hole in it there until he gets beat low to the glove side.
Goalie to the bench, substitution made.
Well, you can't pull the whole team, so you might as well pull the goaltender. He deserves a break here. He's getting as there was just no resistance against their opponent.
Chicago's hammered home yet another goal. They've got a lot of shots, and now they've got goals to show for their effort. They've won the neutral zone faceoff. You win that, and you don't know how to chase. They chase you. We can start some danger here. Perfect centering pass. Oh, what a terrific save in close.
Oh, Vasco, let's eat. Oh, please let me get one on that.
Almost into trouble. Keeps it going up the wing.
Chicago's been able to do just about anything that they've wanted at this point in the game. They've skated well, they've moved the puck well, they've controlled possession almost all night long.
Shoots. That's a score!
Well, he was perfect till now. But, you know what?
Scooped up by Ryan Suter. Great job stopping and holding.
the saves they need.
Jack away by Keith. And the pitcher. He's held up against the boards. Pitching this one to Kane. Oh, he's got this one, but can they catch up to him? Gathered up again by Saul. Marvelous save. No time on that one.
You want to score goals, you have to go to this area.
Marvelous save. A great chance was no chance. The period comes to an end. Woo! We all need a rest now. We are entering the third period. Based on the first two, what are you expecting to happen?
Minnesota's got a real tough task ahead of them as we get ready for the third period. They know they're facing a hot goaltender. They know they've created a lot of chances. They need a bounce. They need to get a greasy goal. In order to do that, you've got to put yourself right in front of the goaltender.
Brodin's been dry for so long. He's out of things that he can change. He's changed the tape on his stick from white to black, and then black to white. He changes the way he drives to the rink. After a while, it gets into your head so deeply, you forget to move your feet. And I was in a slump. My coach has always told me, move your feet, and the points will follow.
Puck cover, whistle blown.
Chicago's been humming along offensively. Well, it's no wonder. Their player's been on such a significant point streak. Every game, it seems, he finds a way to create offense, whether he finishes the play himself or sets somebody else up.
They win the draw. Point blast. He scores. His very first goal this year. He's had his chances and finally cashes in for goal number one. And that's a face-off win. Looking to Niederreiter.
Thank you.
own win. The Blackhawks have it up the wing. Puck grab, they've got it ready. Oh, terrific save on a great chance. And missed opportunity from this close in. New York's going to bring to conclusion this long homestand. Couldn't think of a better team to have coming in at the end. Good job on that faceoff, tying the man up. Nicely into the zone. One into another. Paddled aside. Big drive. Great opportunity denied.
This puck he stopped, guys, but it was just enough to keep it out of the net.
Over 8 minutes left to go in the third. The lead has just been cut in half. Let's see if momentum changes now. Good faceoff win. Oh, his helmet mask. Yeah, you heard it. Him break the mask. Good work with the stick. Oh, and he's hammered.
Minnesota's confidence has grown as this game has gone on. They were down early.
Wonderful stop. The Blackhawks continue on at center. A shot. Right at the net. Oh, close call there. That shot cannot miss the net. Give me that chance. I'll take it. Nicely into the zone. Save. Minnesota's continuing on up the wing. Stays onside to the middle. Save! At the front of the net. Gonged away. That's a good solid hit. He'll feel that one. Oh, wonderful play. Puck is thrown to Richie. Gathered up again by Eric Staal. And he steps in. Slid to Eric Staal. Good save there. Goaltender pass. Gets in and he'll look over his options. Outstanding work with the glove. Minnesota's in possession as they move up the wing. Nearing the final minute of regulation. Puck picked up here. Terrific save with no reaction time whatsoever. You talk about cutting down the angle. Perfectly executed by the goaltender.
Well, for my highlight, I think this is it, guys, but it's an unbelievable stop. It keeps his team in striking distance of the lead.
And they've won that draw. And it's nabbed by Coyle. Shot, missed the net.
Boy, if he puts that one in, that gives them a real serious chance to get back in this game.
Minnesota's yanking their goalie. Nothing to wait for here. He's net open. He scores. Chicago's prevailed again on the faceoff of the neutral zone. Good body contact. Minnesota's moving the puck up the wing. Back in his defensive end together. Minnesota's pulling their goalie for the extra man. Fires! Wonderful save on upturn. He scores! Minnesota's deficit is now only one. And there's time remaining here in the third period to get it even. Face-off win, let's see what develops. Dumped in. He's pinned and held at the boards. There can only be one, that is the first, and this is it. Victory number one.
Not many people make it to this level. He's now proven he can succeed here as well. His first NHL win.
A fun game for us. We hope it was for you. That's our show. More games to come. If they match this one, they will be special. So long for now.
Please like this video, leave a comment, and subscribe.